Marshall here, explaining how we made this spin art machine from Tinker Crate. So, we started out with the box. It was just a normal box with all the materials inside that you need to make it with. So, we started out with that, and of course there was instructions with it, so we had a little bit of help with that, but the science behind on why it turns. So right here, there's a little thing called a breadboard.
Okay, let me zoom in.
There's a breadboard which basically tells what the motor needs to do, or how it kind of needs to work. And then this is a power source on how it gets its power. This needs to be connected. And the wires go through. This is the wire that connects to the motor to give it the power. And this is what tells the gives the breadboard power to then tell the motor what to do. And with the motor, if you press on, if you were to press it on, it would start spinning because this would tell the battery, since it's on, would tell the breadboard that it needs to start moving, and that's what these are for. Which would then, this would go out, go into the motor, which then will tell it what to do, and then, of course, you'd open up your paint pen, and as it's spinning, you can drop a little bit of paint onto it to then make some cool designs. And then, once you've finished all your designs, you can then stop it. It takes a little bit to slow down, so you might need to wait a little bit for that.
And
little sounds.
Mesmerizing.
I kind of wish that there was a better way to slow it down faster, but anyway, so yes, it will slow down, and because of its spinning, it will carry, if it goes fast, there's kind of
centrifugal force.
Yeah, that will go down, make cool designs, and then you can open it up, take your paper, and then have your beautiful art.
And who got you this?
Muggle. Thank you.
And who's Muggle?
My grandma.